首先好多謝阿 Basel 俾個機會我哋今日同大家分享阿 Alan
講幾十年嘅啲
經歷啦。
咁
我覺得今日特別好有意義嘅係因為Alan 除咗即係同佢共事咗二十年之外咧，仲係一個非常之好嘅朋友嘅。咁可以同台同 Alan 分享非常之有意義嘅今日。我仲記得喺第一次識 Alan 嘅時候咧，係喺1999年喺遊街嘅時候，咁當其時係我仲喺美國讀緊書，翻嚟香港去旅行嘅時候咧，咁Art Asia Pacific 啊 Elaine 就帶我去遊街，咁一入到遊街咧就唔係一啲好靚嘅即係artwork 嘅 display， 但係當其時咧就見到一入到去咧就見到個電視機咧就係一個pornographic 嘅 video， 咁就無限 loop， 就好似今時今日。Tumblr 裏邊咧嘅嗰啲 pornographic gif 咁嘅樣，咁啊個 artist 嘅 creation， 跟住我就覺得哇咁正嘅呢個地方香港，即係因為喺我印象中香港一路啲藝術嘅團體啊或者空間都幾傳統嘅當其時，
而
自此咧就係我覺得就即係 Videotage 係一個即係非常之 inspiring 嘅機構，亦都之後隨之之後嗰二十年咧不停同 Alan 合作。我覺得如果要去形容 Alan 淨係一個 artist 嘅話咧，實在係太過唔夠啦。因為 Alan 咧有一生人裏邊咧做咗非常之多嘅嘢。咁佢翻咗好多機構啦，包括 co-found 咗 Videotage 啦，其中一個喺亞洲區最早期嘅 non-profit organisation 啦，
翻咗 Microwave Festival 啦，喺1996年。
Alan 係一個 mentor 啦，對於好多人嚟講，對於好多香港嘅年輕嘅藝術家，應該講話唔同年代嘅藝術家咧，
都俾 Alan 咧係
去mentor 過，亦都即係照顧過。Alan 係一個好好嘅 curator 啦，亦都curate 咗好多嘅 show， 由香港嘅博物館令到有媒體藝術嘅展覽啦，以至到好 cutting edge 嘅一啲 program 都係 Alan 去諗出嚟。Alan 亦都係一個甚至乎係一個administrator 同埋有時 accountant 添，因為咧我記得同 Alan 喺 Videotage 通宵喺度砌嗰啲單咧，點樣做 audit report
啊？
當然 Alan 係一個非常之重要嘅 video artist， 佢代表香港第一次參加威尼斯雙年展，第49屆嘅威尼斯雙年展。佢亦都喺好多唔同嘅大大小小嘅展覽啦 ，local 同埋國際嘅展覽去展示過佢嘅 work。對於我嚟講咧 ，Alan 係一個即係好多人講叫 Alan 做錄像仙姑咧，我會覺得 Alan 係一個大佬咯，係一個即係非常之點講啊，照顧後輩啊嘅一個人。所以我覺得總括嚟講咧 ，Alan 係如果冇 Alan 嘅話，香港就呢個媒體藝術嘅歷史咧就會冇咗一大橛，
好多 local
嘅一啲歷史。所以我哋今日嘅 talk 咧會係好希望可以從 Alan 個人嘅一啲故仔，以至去講一講香港嘅一啲成個歷史嘅一啲演變啊，去睇下 Alan 嘅 work 以及咧香港嘅整個藝術圈。咁不如我哋講講你小朋友嘅時候先。
Let's talk about your childhood first.
Alan， 你曾經講過咧，你爹哋係醫生嚟啦。
咁
之後你爹哋依個咁嘅細個經驗對你之後創作有好大嘅影響。可唔可以講講當其時你爹哋點樣 inspire 你？
因為我諗香港真係一個好capitalist 嘅城市嚟。
Hong Kong is a true capitalist city， but that's not my dad。
買。
He didn't like to go shopping。
咁咧佢就好中意整嘢。
He loved making things。
咁我哋細個嗰時佢就整咗一個 speaker 俾我，用一個
for me。
發布膠，
咁咧就裏邊
掛
一
個窿，咁就
藏
咗個 speaker， 咁就整完之後咧就成個好似粒色仔咁樣嘅，咁就我就將嗰個 speaker 就掛咗喺我個床頭，咁我每晚聽歌暗瞓嘅時候咧就係用嗰個 speaker， 咁啊佢又自己又整咗啲佢用一個旅行夾就整咗一個唱片俾自己啦，佢其實整咗好多嘢。
instrument for himself to play music. He's made so many things. I really admire him.
整嘢俾你係令到你覺得對 machine好有一個 fascination。
So that drove you to become fascinated by machines, right?
有好多嘢係可以自己整㗎。
Yes, I learned from him. We can make so many things ourselves.
佢都覺得你自己學得㗎啦。
He told me, if you want to learn how to play the piano, learn it yourself. You don't need a teacher. Just look at the musical scores, and then just put down small labels on the keys on the piano, which one is key C, and then learn it yourself.
So he really encouraged self-learning, and I wasn't afraid with technology.
He gave me a camera when I was
camera 110.
That's my first camera. 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 That's my first camera.
That's my first
camera. That's my first camera. That's my first camera. That's my first camera. That's my first camera. That's my first camera. That's my first camera. That's my first
Flash
即係要好小心咁用，
flash,
即係要好小心咁用，菲林好似得廿四格嘅啫。咁即係要用就要要爹哋買個另外一個菲林，所以其實要好小心。我喺大阪博覽會嗰陣時候已經係十四格啦，成日都要問問爹哋攞菲林就唔係幾好啦。咁所以就要慳錢，然後跟住我就發現。
原來影相都要有學問嘅，即係都要諗下點樣樣。所以從嗰陣時開始，其實我對攝影係有興趣，但係我又覺得自己做得唔好。當時70年代嘅香港係點樣樣咧？即係大阪嘅博覽會係即係technology係好比香港高好多。
They were more advanced in terms of technology, right? In the 70s, Osaka Expo,
well,
the theme was about the future world. When I got there, I saw many architectural projects completed with art.
Art project，我只係見到有好多video projection，有啲甚至係啲霧裏邊啊，有啲光啊，咁啲霧裏邊啲光咧又發覺，咦，原來個光係完全睇到曬嗰條光影嘅喎。咁同埋日本佢哋係嗰陣時個博覽會係sell佢哋啲product啦，因為六十年代嗰陣時係其實呢個70年呢個事咧就係。
日本愛嚟振興佢哋嘅經濟，因為佢六十年代嗰陣時已經係個重工業好發達，所以我哋六十年代香港咧係好多佢哋嘅即係電視機啦、電視機啦、TV、aircon、the rice cooker、everything from Japan。所以嗰陣時日本對我哋嚟講就係一個很發達嘅科技好發達嘅一個國家，咁佢啲design又好勁啊嘛，嗰次嘅博覽會。
我去睇佢哋poster，佢哋出咗好多款poster，同埋佢哋亦都有一啲好好嘅，即係令到我哋覺得好賓至如歸嘅一啲嘅節款袋啦。譬如去抌印仔啦，我哋嗰陣時去每一個館咧可以有個印仔去抌啦，而嗰啲成個簿仔又係好靚嘅，所有嘢都係好靚。你會覺得香港冇呢啲嘢嘅咁。講到即係當其時日本嗰個博覽會俾你影響，除咗係
即係好high tech之外，仲係好humanistic。即係對你之後，譬如擺喺你嘅artwork啊，或者係你策展嘅一啲項目，都好有影響。即係譬如説係，即係technology其實係可以去拯救世界，同埋去對抗世界末日。係啊，因為其實都。
細路仔嘅時候，我會問爹哋一啲問題咯，即係譬如當我哋讀書發現原來世界末日係2012，咁我計一計我就發覺咦，我應該嗰時仲在生喎，咁所以覺得咁點算啊？咁即係問爹哋點算咧？咁我爹哋就會話可能有啲會好嘅人咧，即係好嘅人會勝多過 啲唔好嘅人，咁呢個一樣嘢啦，亦都可能好嘅人咧係會識得點樣利用 technology 令到我哋個 世界會好啲。咁嗰陣時其實講緊都係環保嘅問題啦。
So we were talking about environmental protection issues。
嗰陣時冇諗咁多啊，關於戰爭嘅，係戰爭之後先至開始我諗多啲關於戰爭。係嗰陣時係覺得呢個世界係會末日，係因為我哋太過
pollution
太多啦咁樣樣。
之後
你都覺得即係 art 係可以其實結合 technology 可以令到嗰個世界可以有改變。
To make the world a better place.
我諗我最記得
I remember.
即係係咯，即係爹哋講話，即係如果我哋用呢個 technology 係可以令到世界未唔會世界末日呢一個樣嘢，同埋加上我希望即係世界和平啊呢啲咁樣嘅嘢咧，都係嗰陣時開始 form 呢件事咧，咁我就對technology 係有個 fascination 咯，即係覺得如果我想人呢、這個這個人類呢一件事係可以延續落去，
if、
我哋想將一啲好嘅嘢延續落去，咁我一定要借助啲 technology。咁當然我亦都係講緊我係一個，即、就、係、是、我對未來係有好多想像，因為我嗰次去大阪嘅時候係發覺、未來原來係可以被想像啦，你可以建構下你個未來啦。咁所以我覺得 technology 好似係。我哋需要做嘅一樣嘢咯。
之後你就去中學完咗之後啦，就去理工學院當其時，咁就要選科。咁點解嗰陣時你即係唔選藝術？
How come you didn't choose art？
就去選咗 radiology，
其實都有選嘅，不過就唔收啦。咁但係我其實都中意做醫院嘅，一我就即係真係喺醫院大噶啦，即
係。I grew up in a hospital。
因為我住喺醫院隔離嘅啫，係細我嗰陣時，咁所以咧我亦都唔覺得醫院係厭惡嘅，即係我係亦都覺得佢係一個好stable 嘅工作啦。咁同埋加上我發現原來喺醫院係可以揀一啲有趣嘅工作，即係我覺得radiology 對我嚟講係非常之有趣啦。因為佢係有好多新嘅機器啦，有好多新嘅。其實係我入行嘅時候，就正正係 radiology 最蓬勃地創一啲新嘅modality 啦。即係我入去嘅時候，可能係淨係仲係 X-ray 比較當道啲嚇 ，X-ray 用咗成八年咁滯啦。咁但係咧，我入行嘅時候80年代嘅時候咧，就開始 CT 啦、ultrasound 啦，跟住再之後90年代 MRI 啦。其實呢啲 modality 而家係好 common， 但係係我眼睇住佢一個 generation 一個 generation 咁出現咯，對我嚟講係好 inspiring， 因為每一個 technology 其實係講緊用乜嘢方法去 visualize 一啲我哋睇唔到嘅嘢。咁以前我哋可能中學嘅時候會有 microscope， 我哋發覺原來有個 lens 咧用光咧，我哋可以睇到呢啲嘢。咁而家我哋係講緊啲 invisible 嘅光去睇一啲 invisible 嘅嘢。係啊，咁但係睇到啦，終於我哋睇到。咁我覺得係對我嚟講係嗰個 image making 嗰個 process 係好有趣咯，所以我係好開心可以讀到點樣樣 produce 呢啲 image 背後嘅嗰啲 physics 啊，嗰個原理啊，其實我覺得好 fascinating。
你後期即係用 video 嘅創作都係一個 landscape medium 去 visualize 我哋嘅世界有啲咩共同嘅，你覺得同 radiology？
我覺得做 image 個方法係好接近嘅，因為有時我睇即係我哋睇，譬如睇一張 X-ray 片咁樣啦，你會真係。即係 inch， 即係逐寸，即係好似啲警察咁樣樣啊，地氈式搜索咁啊，即係逐寸逐寸咁睇噶嘛。咁同埋成件事，你點樣擺嗰、那個即係個身體，點樣去擺落去嗰張相上面？其實都係有啲，即係我哋係有我哋自己喺個行業裏邊嘅一啲嘅美學啦。你當下咁我去做 art 嘅時候，其實我又會 apply 咗呢啲睇嘢嘅方法，同埋呢啲點樣樣去 frame 一件事嘅方法。我諗我都有啲 scientific 嘅方法去睇嘢。
你好多創作嘅時候都唔係淨係諗嗰個aesthetic 嘅嘢，而係裏邊可能會計埋一啲好 mathematical 嘅嘢啊，甚至乎即係啲 algorithm 點樣去 construct 嗰啲 image。
See how you can construct images。
我希望我可以做到即係直情做到一個新嘅 MRI 機出嚟
做 image 啦，但係其實
就未必可以啦。所以我而家用嘅譬如而家用嘅 video 啦嚇，嗰陣時用嘅係 analog 嘅 video 啦。咁我自己玩佢嘅時候發現，哦原來可以 feedback 原來可以點樣
control，
原來啲 noise 係咁樣嚟，咁啲 noise 可以點樣將佢變成我嘅美學嘅一部分。咁呢啲都係嗰陣時喺度用嗰個 medium 嘅時候，然後跟住睇下點樣可以同個 medium 融為一體去諗呢啲事啦。
咁之後你就好快即係喺理工學院嘅時候咧，就開始接觸即係藝術依樣嘢，就係因為你變成咗進念嘅 member， 然之後俾咗好多 inspiration 你。進念就其實係香港一個其中最早期嘅一個 experimental 嘅一個 performing art group。咁你可唔可以講一講當其時你喺進念度點樣去 inspire 你？
我在進念做 member 嗰陣時，即係每個月俾$60做 member 啦。咁好似係$60啦。
$60
就可以睇佢哋嘅 program。咁佢哋有啲咩 program 咧？就係每個月都會有一啲可能係英國電視台 Channel 4嘅 program 啦，無論係 MTV 又好，或者紀錄片，或者
係
電影。咁我就可能每個禮拜上去一次兩次。咁就喺上面睇呢啲香港睇唔到嘅一啲 program 啦，咁從而又認識到一啲即係原來呢啲就係art film 啦，或者係原來 MTV 係咁樣喎咁樣啦，咁然後又思考下。咁音樂同影像有咩關係啊？因為其實我好中意聽歌嘛，即係我爹哋都係做喇叭俾我，咁所以係我會成日都希望自己做音樂嘅，其實，但係就。即係礙於真係冇學過鋼琴啊嗰類啦，咁所以其實做音樂就問水啲，所以就諗住不如係啦，做啲同佢哋有關嘅，同音樂有關嘅嘢。咁所以video 其實都幾近㗎啦，幾近㗎啦，咁就幾好喎，咁咪試下咯。
喺1983年咧，香港就有一個歌德學院同進念同 Art Centre 就 present 咗一個 workshop， 就係我諗都係一個非常之 benchmarking 喺當。其時利用 video 去做 exhibition 啊，又或者用 video 去做創作啊。咁其後進念就用咗好多即係 video 呢個媒體擺喺一啲 experimental performance 嗰度。Alan， 你當其時喺進念就即係拍咗好多嘢啦。即係我好多，譬如好多朋友或者當其時點解去睇進念都因為你個 fans 嚟睇睇嗰啲 video。你當其時喺進念度點樣用 video 去融入喺 performing art 裏邊或者？
Inside theatre performance.
我大部分嘅時間都係幫Danny， 即係進念嘅 artistic director， 就係做 documentation 啦。咁但係我做嘅時候，因為真係做咗好多次開，即係其實應該一兩次之後，我已經開始問自己，咁唔係次次都動個機喺度就咁做啦。咁應該係咪有一啲有啲嘢想可以幫到個戲咧咁樣，咁所以我做嘅時候，我會諗好多嗰個 framing 啦，會諗下點樣樣去 plan 啦，或者係 plan 個時間啦，點解要 plan 啦？我會不停咁樣問自己，點解要有 camera movement 啦？點解呢個時候你要有一個 effect， 或者要有個 fade in 啊，或者有任何一樣嘢，你點解要咁樣控制呢個機咧？因為我諗我會想自己作為一個operator， 即係個鏡頭 operator， 我想人哋好舒服咁樣樣。好似見到我又，但係又見唔到我嘅嗰種感覺，但係亦都見到套戲嘅，即係我唔想搶咗套戲嘅作為一個主角啦。咁所以其實係有好多嘢我去試咯。
除咗 documentation 之外，你當其時因為有 performance 做咗《借頭借路》呢個作品，有冇講講？
呢個其實係好得意啊！嗰陣時我都唔知道自己係會做創作嘅，咁我就真係借咗阿 Danny Young 其中一個演出啦，咁我就 發現啊，呢個演出咧，其實佢有兩個台上有兩個幕，咁然後咧就有啲人匿喺個幕後邊，咁然後跟住就到其時咧就行出嚟點一點頭，跟住就去翻另外嗰邊嘅幕嗰度。咁我就覺得呢一個 form 咧係好有趣，我就覺得。因為台上的幕和我用電子的 screen 用電子的 wipe 去製作一個電子的幕 electronic wipe 其實是很近似的，我就覺得那個人在個台上面在個幕後面你就會感覺到他的存在，如果在個電子的幕的後面你可能你不知道會不會感覺到他存在呢，然後跟著我再問第二個問題，就是 frame 的邊其實都是個 frame 的邊就是個電子的 image 的幕嚟噶嘛，其中一個幕。咁如果我再喺嗰度都有一個公仔會走出嚟嘅時候，咁佢嘅存在喺邊度？咁我喺度咁樣問嘅時候，就做咗一個咁樣嘅 video， 係啦。咁呢個 dream 其實你而家見到呢個係我用一個 vertical hole， 即係電視舊嘅電視會有嘅，就係 vertical， 即係上下嘅一個 hold 住佢嘅一個 lock 嚟嘅。咁我將個 vertical hole 校歪咗，即係有少少 misuse 佢啦。咁就令到本來個 frame 咧就跳高咗。半格或者係四分一格，咁我就將呢啲嘅 misuse 咧就記錄咗成為一張 still picture。咁喺個 video 裏邊其實都有呢、這、一個有呢一張 still picture 嘅，係啊。咁就我就用咗借咗佢大約20秒嘅 footage， 但係我就 generate 咗一個5分鐘嘅 video， 所以就叫借頭借路。
當其時，即係永年經常都講框架，即係佢講
And grids are mentioned. So there is framework in society. It determines how we see the society. And there are also philosophical issues concerning how you place frameworks in your video creation. What kind of inspirations have you got? In relation to frames or framing, it is very important to people using the camera. In fact,
Some time ago,
I played with things outside frames. So my first experiment is really about frame. And in the past, there were a lot of cultural policies in my previous organization. And so this concept of frames has been in our arts practice.We also have cultural frames or framing, which is very broad.
Well,
you made use of a lot of videos and also in performing art too. And then in 1992, you were invited by the Museum of Art to be an independent artist and create an installation.
So,
was there a very big impact to you at that time? Many institutions.
Are not that established
in identifying themselves as artists. Well, that is really something.
So,
what were your feelings at that time? Because it's the first time that you were identified as an artist and you were asked to create a piece. And it is actually a creation in a space but not a stage. So, can you share your feelings? Well, that was very special.Because that was the first time I adopted a sculptural idea into a video. Back then, there wasn't a flat screen. It's like a box. So I thought that it had a body. So I thought of how to use this body to transform it so that it becomes another body. I find that very interesting. And so I have created something that is very hairy, and then the hair can move, and there is a mouth, which is the video. So the mouth also can open and shut. It is like a hairy figure that can eat people or swallow people. Before the opening of City Vibrance, I went to ACC of the States. When I returned, the show ended already. When I worked on that show, I could play with this new concept. And then when I was in the US, because I received the ACC grant, so I was introduced as an artist. So all of a sudden, it seems that I am enlightened and awakened. I remember that I had just done a show in a museum, so I am an artist. But still, I could not adapt to that new status. So until I completed the sculpture, the sculpture, after completing the sculpture, I got a photo, and I realized that the museum had added a white carpet so that the sculpture could really stand out. And I realized that this is the way how museum presented art. That is the way of presenting art. That is something new that I have learned. And at that time, I realized that artists can work in that way. Museum professionals can work in that way. So only then I knew that there still are a lot of things that I don't know about art. This is something interesting in video art. Well, it started from a TV set at home, and then you can watch television companies' programs, and then on the stage, you can do documentation, and then it becomes single channel work, and later on, it can become an installation or an object of an installation. So that is rather queer. It is a very uncertain form, and in different occasions and scenarios, it can deliver different meaning. So at that time, later on you established Videotage, and then it used to be Firebird Film Club. And at that time, why is it that it later on became a video art organization? Well, for a Firebird Film Club every year, it organizes an experimental video award. And entries from all parts of the world can be accepted, and then an award will be presented. Well, that award started in the 70s, or that club started in the 70s. And when I went there as student helper, that was in the 80s. That was already a late stage of their club. And they were established in the 70s. They wanted to promote films. And then in the 80s, well, I'm talking about independent film medium, 16mm, Super 16mm, or Super 8mm. These media could not be found easily in Hong Kong. They were expensive already. And so people changed to use video. Because of that, club filmmakers have become professional filmmakers. Some have become film critics, and some are creators. So they work on films, and they are of the view that they need to change. They cannot just play the video. They can't name themselves a Fiery Bird Club and so on. So they have to come up with a name. And it was not composed by the board. Together with another staff, we went to Gothic, and when we were waiting for the head, then we realized that there were some posters, and we just took a bet. We saw a poster named Montage, and then we just changed the program name. We just combined the word video and montage, and so it became Videotage. So it's not based on video, so it is not read Montaga. Well, from the poster, there is the suffix
Tage.
In the days of Flamingo, you also had some programs, but in Hong Kong, there are not enough artists working on Super 8mm. So all of a sudden, you yourself have turned into five artists. In 1986, that was the last program of Flamingo, and at that time, all founders of the club did not care much about the club, and the experimental award was also changed. It was known as Alternative Film and Video Festival later on. Why alternative? Because people may not be able to accept experimental. So since we are non-mainstream, so that's why alternative. And at that time, we
had that query.
We wanted to collect alternative film videos, but we did not have too much capital. We did not have a big enough network, and so we did not have enough programs. The staff said we could produce our own programs, so student helpers also started to make their programs. I remember that at the beginning, I said to myself, okay, I can play the role as a director who had just completed studying film in the US. So what will I shoot if I'm from Hollywood? What will I shoot? Then I thought of an idea and I just produced it. What will a feminist shoot? Then I have again come up with another film. One person can come up with many ideas. Let's say if you are a fish, what will you do? You can continue to think along this route, and then you will have many, many ideas. The staff has created many names for us, a Watermelon Film Company, for example. So there are many film companies being born, so we can participate in that festival. Today, it is difficult for us to imagine that there is only one artist in the show, and then, in fact, there are 10 artists coming up with 10 different entries. Yes, many.
So,
how do you feel today about this change? This is not possible today. Today, if we do not have enough programs, but that one is full of fun.
So
we can turn into so many different roles, and then I realized that I can be organizer, producer, administrator, or even artist. So I realized that there are a lot of things that I can play with in the art field. I am interested in all roles. I want to try them all. So from that day onwards, I believe artist is like a magician. He can do whatever he likes. Then I can also do whatever I like in the future. Yes, you can turn yourself into a fish. True. And then later, after Videotage was established, Flamingo was already disbanded. And then in the first 10 years, you did not have funding. So in the first 10 years at that time, how was the art scene? How did you operate Videotage?
In the first 10 years,
at first we wanted to have a screening once a year, but then we did not have enough programs, and so we did it once every 2 years. So sometimes we work in my previous group, and then sometimes we rented the space under Urban Council or Art Center or Fringe Club. And because we had to rent a place, so originally Videotage was a video program. Later on, we have to establish an organization to rent venue. And every year, we organized screening. And in the past 10 years, if possible, we did one screening every 2 years or every year.
Within 10 years, we had organized 6 to 7
annual screenings.
Every time,
there are 2 to 3 programs. Usually, I was in them.
自己帶住個三槍，有時問進念者個三槍嘅 projector 咁就。
So I sometimes borrowed a projector.
當其時嘅圈子其實同今日好唔同，因為今日我哋有即係 commercial gallery 啊。
Today we have commercial galleries.
Commercial gallery represent artists.
And then commercial galleries will present artists. We have museums, curators.
當你回想翻當其時香港嗰個 art scene 係點樣？
How was the art scene in Hong Kong at that time?
譬如蘇斯歐咁樣，佢可能係
For instance, 蘇斯歐，
佢會做 video art 啦，但係又會做 music video 啦。
She worked on video art as well as music video. So how was the scene back then?
唔係好多人做創作，尤其是係即係
覺得係比較 people were on creation，
所以
there were even fewer
along the cutting edge。
So we went everywhere to do different things. For example, Zuni will commission us to do something in CCDC as well. Many organizations commissioned us to work. We also did commercial things.
Well, on one occasion,
I was almost shot in one of the KTVs. So we did almost everything. How was it different from now?
Today, as an artist, you need to
consider whether things can sell and whether galleries are willing to represent you.
Multi-talented 嘅一個人，即係樣嘢都要做下。
So back then, you were multi-talented. You had to work on almost everything. You are an artist, but that is not your full-time job.
So,
do you think that this is even more avant-garde back then? At that time, people really would like to be avant-garde and experimental and cutting-edge. These are things we would like to achieve.
已經咁多，即係譬如有。大家都可能熟悉啊個 art market 係點樣，咁可能
people are more familiar with the art market. So what they are doing is for the sake of the art market.
所有嘢都未成熟咧，
所有嘢都係 open-ended。 Everything was not mature. Everything was open-ended. So we think that there are a lot that we can try. It's full of fun. We don't need to consider where the buyers are and where the audiences are. We don't care. As long as there are opportunities, we just try them.
Why?
Did you have this energy? It's enjoyable. It's interesting. It's funny.
同醫院裏邊做嘅嘢好唔同。
It's very different from work in hospital. Very different.
所以我先至覺得點解我可以翻嚟成晚嘢？
Even after a day's work, even after not having slept for 2 days, I can still continue the work because it is full of fun. It's like playing mahjong. My mother would play mahjong after working a night shift, and she enjoyed herself a lot. I also enjoy video a lot. You are the first artist who will compare
with mahjong. And then in the 90s,
you are more established because in Hong Kong, there is constant NGO funding, and there are parasites running space and so on. And later, you moved to Oil Street.
Can you
recollect the situation there? Well, when you went to Oil Street, well, that was a special occasion. I cannot remember that movie back then.
遊街其實我哋係差唔多集合咗好多嗰陣時係好出色嘅香港，你可以講話係差唔多第一代80年代成長嘅嗰批藝術家。
So those who grew up in the 80s, those artists had set up office or studio there.
Videotage
had an office on the top floor.
其實嗰度望出去就係 當佢走
啦。If you look out of the window, you will see Eastern Corridor there.
望到個東區走廊，然後跟住我就做咗 recycling cinema， 即係去咗威尼斯嗰個 work， 係都係喺嗰度做嘅。咁我哋其實喺油街嗰度係好誒，因為有進念啦，有啲 archi 嘅 firm 啊 ，fashion 嘅 firm 啊，即係好多 designer artist。嗰個 cluster 其實係香港第一次試嘅啫，我諗佢哋都未試過有咁多 artist 聚居喺同一個地點。咁我哋。
In the past, there have not been so many artists living in the same place.
So I think it was rather big cluster. And
we have been there for around a year, and later on, the government wanted to demolish Isle Street, and we are asked to leave. We really missed the place. In that 1 year period, we accomplished a lot of things.
政府其實就都冇乜特別去發展到個油街，直至到真係最近而家先至叫做
Until recently, a building was built, and it has been 20 odd years. So from the point with no funding to the point when you started to have funding, and then an art zone for non-profit organizations to showcase their work. How do you feel about the change? Is it better or are there more restrictions?
我開頭攞 funding 嘅時候，我就覺得一定係好咗嘅，因為有好多本來冇諗嘅嘢咧，都開始諗要做啊！即係譬如拍咗啲 video， 咁嗰陣時放完就即刻就走啦，咁就唔理啦。但係而家咧拍咗啲 video， 放完之後要諗下，咁我哋 collect 咗咁多 artist 嘅 work， 咁我哋要唔要 promote 佢哋咧？咁要唔要做下 distribution 咧？可能拎去幫手拎去外國做下 distribution 啦。或者拎去做下 archive 啦，或者係其他嘢。其實我哋都嗰陣時係開始有 funding 嘅時候咧，就開始即係令到即係 Videotage 呢一個組織開始要諗下點樣樣可以成個香港嘅 video art 嘅先，或者係 media art 嘅先都開始被照顧啦。咁所以我哋係諗緊好多新嘅項目啦。咁但係亦都同時間當然有唔好嘅地方啦，就係
個 funding
其實唔係好夠我做咁多嘢嘅，其實好多時都係揀嚟嘅，有啲咁所以亦都係因為有 funding 可以寫 report 啦，有好多即係所謂繁文縟節啦嚇，咁我哋要做好多文件嘅嘢啊，咁呢啲其實都令到嗰個創作嘅 energy 有啲有啲削減咗。
As a result, we have less energy for creation, and there are things that we need to follow.
變咗你唔夠膽話啊，其實擁曬啲錢去做某一樣嘢，咁下年嘅 funding 咁會唔會嚟咧？咁你每一年都要跟住跟住咁做啦。
You are worried that next year there would no longer be funding. So that means it's like helping a mahjong establishment to operate instead of playing mahjong yourself. Well, today we are at Art Basel. The whole art world is getting more and more internationalized and sophisticated, and very soon we'll have M+ and other museums.How do you see the future?
即係既由一個打緊麻雀嘅人，
so you used to be a mahjong player，
就變成 artist 啦。
Now you are an artist.
Well, now Hong Kong is actually a casino.
即係有做一啲唔同嘅，譬如藝術發展局嘅film and media 主席，即係做政策嘅。即係我覺得呢樣嘢都變成係一個即係 Alan 好獨有嘅，亦都係好多香港藝術家好獨有嘅一啲identity 啦。佢除咗係做創
So apart from production and creation, many artists have to take part in the establishment and policy making of many organizations. What do you think about the future of Hong Kong?
Now there are a lot of things arising
from your strive for rights and resources
in the past. So now today, it seems that a lot of things are established. And we also look forward to major big international institutions. In the past decades,
from a mahjong player to an operator of a mahjong establishment, how do you see the full picture of Hong Kong being a big casino in the future? What are your feelings about the past 30 years when you look back? ADC,
現在還未做到他應該要做到的角色,
right now, still cannot play the role that it ought to be. Well, there isn't really sound cultural and arts policy. But I hope that I can help a bit about, for example, distribution of funding. Now, we are still talking about, we are still very reliant on government funding. I really hope that one day there will be more companies that will offer sponsorship to arts projects. If there are more and more, for example, foundations that will sponsor art projects, then
artists
in Hong Kong can do what they want.
同埋唔使成日都會有嗰啲話 即係鬧政府得唔得啊？ 攞唔攞到ADC錢啊？呢啲咁樣嘅，you
don't need to worry about whether you can get ADC funding after criticising the government. Even if you can't get ADC funding, you can get other sources of funds. Then the whole scene will be healthier.
麻雀館開始變做賭場啦。The macro environment has turned from a mahjong establishment to casino. But
we are not too sure whether businessmen are taking part in the casino yet.
So,
not only
is
art policy necessary, if you want to cook tasty soup, if you want a lot of fun, there is the need for many stakeholders. Yes, the whole ecology. Let's talk about your artwork.
就係其中一個好重要Ellen嘅signature 就係TV
Game of the Year
嘅作品裏邊涉及咗好多社會嘅議題啦，同埋 lot of social affairs were involved,
and video is used to interfere with social development and promote the
society.
Feminist movement is also represented in Ellen's artwork.
你嘅作品裏邊有咁多都關於社會性嘅嘢。
Why are so many of your works related to social affairs?
我覺得如果要講 technology 同埋人咧，我
If I want to talk about technology and people, it is really essential to talk about the society.
譬如而家呢一個古靈咒咁樣啦，咁嗰陣時係
For example, this TV game of the year,
古靈咒，即係六四呢件事。
Well, the June 4 incident
was a shock.
如果大家唔知道，其實嗰個古靈咒其實做咩咧，就係攞咗李鵬嘅喺電視上邊宣佈appearance on TV,
有一堆電視機圍圈咁啦，就好似咁樣啦，即係我意思係其實咧，影嗰陣時就唔係圍圈嘅，不過我剪到佢嗰陣時係圍圈，有一堆咁樣啦。咁之後低咗，跟住我就覺得呢，其實咧，咦，其實咧，影嗰陣時就唔係圍圈嘅，不過我剪到佢嗰陣時係圍圈，有一堆咁樣啦。咁之後低咗，跟住我就覺得呢，其實咧，影嗰陣時就唔係圍圈嘅，不過我剪到佢嗰陣時係圍圈，有一堆咁樣啦。咁之後低咗，跟住我就覺得呢，其實咧，影嗰陣時就唔係圍圈嘅，不過我剪到佢嗰陣時係圍圈，有一堆咁樣啦。咁之後低咗，跟住我就覺得呢，其實咧，影嗰陣時就唔係圍圈嘅，不過我剪到佢嗰陣時係圍圈 搞啦。所以
惡搞你個惡搞係早咗即係二十年。係
啊，嗰陣時都幾惡搞。我記得我第一次播，我唔知第一次定第二次播。 跟住咧誒 Videotage manager 就同我講，佢話誒你播嘅時候咧有。誒嗰陣時係新華社有兩個人著住，我哋平時嚟嘅觀眾唔係著西裝嘅。
Usually our audience says did not come in uniform in suits, but then there were two people in suits. They were from Xinhua agency and they left the main cars. He asked whether I knew, and I said I don't know. Then my dad said a phone call was received.
係，即係我覺得係誒。呢一個對我嚟講唔係一個政治嘅宣言啦，嚇。咁但係誒，
係觸
動到一啲神經咯。
But then I think some nerves were touched. I think this is related to video art because it is very instantaneous. It can respond to news.
It can become artist's own
response. 咁
另外就係即係 feminist 嘅有關啦，同啲
queer movement。Contents.
你可唔可以講講 Song of Goddess 呢個 work？ 不如我哋睇睇先。
Can you comment on your work, Song of Goddess? Let's play a video first.
喺開頭一陣。
Just the beginning part.
shot 應該係呢度之後。
The best shot is after this.
咁你可唔可以講下 Song
of Goddess？ But okay, let's keep it secret. Can you tell us something about the philosophy behind Song of the Goddess？
我係用 U-matic 剪接嘅。
I used U-matic for editing.
我用開嗰啲都係普通 video
aids 啊。
頂曬
籠
去到九幾年又 high
aids
啊。呢個用
U-matic，
即係一個 semi-professional 一個 system 去剪。咁啊，故仔其實係講，即係其實係任劍輝白雪仙嘅故仔嚟嘅。不過我就將佢引申成為即係姊妹情咁樣樣嘅一件事啦。因為
任劍輝
喺好似係九一或者九零年嘅時候，佢就唔喺度啦。
passed away in 1991 or 1992, and Bác Xuyên has been with her for a long time. Both of them are renowned Cantonese opera actresses.
差唔多係中環咗我哋粵劇界，講緊都有五六十年嘅一對嘅，即係。
Actually dominated the Cantonese opera scene for 50-60 years. They played lovers roles. Now this image is from
Cantonese opera.
Emperor Li
Hou Zhu. 李后主一个皇帝啦，咁佢就同佢个妻子即系王妃咧，就系可能要分开，咁佢就谂住我自杀，咁但系佢个妻子知道佢想死咧，就走去想救佢，就叫你同我一齐杀佢，咁喺一个咁样嘅戏，咁我就觉得其实好系佢哋，因为佢哋真嘅事迹啊，因为阿雪仙就系啊任剑辉。
The two actresses love because when Yang Jianfei passed away,
if I can get you back,
I am willing to lose my life 100 times.
係好感動嘅，同埋我知道即係白雪仙係仲係好掛念佢，咁我就覺得其實好多有即係有情有義嘅女子啊，女子們啦嚇，即係lesbian又好，或者係即係有姊妹嘅partner啦嚇，咁樣其實都係好感動呢個故事，咁所以我就將佢拍咗一個咁樣嘅。 即係 cross 地域啦，因為好多image其實係嚟自紐約，咁又cross其實 cross gender啦，即係好多咁嘅 crossing 嘅一個故仔咯。
個人嘅 identity 嘅關係係點？因為有好多譬如藝術家會利用 make art 去 explore 自己 identity， 或者係好似好 therapeutic 咁樣，即係利用 make art 嚟到 resolve 緊一啲個人嘅情緒。因為你好多
work
都講你啲女㗎嘛，咁其實即係 make art 對你嚟講係咪即係都一種好 therapeutic 去點講去 resolve 緊一啲 unfinished business 啊？
Unfinished business or emotions?
又真係咁樣？Not really. 因為其實可能我一開始嘅時候，我都會想 explore 一啲 topic
先。咁呢個
topic， 今次呢個 Song of the Goddess 個 topic 係講姊妹啊嘛。咁所以當然係有我嘅部分喺裏邊啦。咁但係好似我頭先講話，一個人化即係。 即係雙面下娃咁樣樣，係啦，即係化好多身都得㗎嘛。咁所以其實我覺得我講咩都得嘅，我又唔會覺得我特別中意要講女性或者係gender或者sexuality呢啲 topic。但係當然我講嘅時候，我係有部分喺裏邊啦。咁等於我講香港 history 嘅時候，當然我都係一個香港人，我都會有我嘅部分喺裏邊一樣嘅啫。When I talk about Hong Kong history,
I am a Hong Kong resident, and there is a part of me inside as well. Congratulations, Alan, for just getting
married. And Hong Kong, when you produced these works, Hong Kong was very conservative. And now, a few days ago, 叫你個老婆，即係非常之感動，即係叫呢個名。即係我諗你用你嘅 artwork， 我諗你經歷咗幾十年喺香港，你有啲咩感覺？即係由一個都幾極度。 歧視同性戀，由一班香港嘅 artist 去亦都好radically去利用創作，去講一啲好多當其時喺 mainstream media 係唔能夠講嘅問題。去到今時今日有得結婚，或者香港都冇得結婚，係你都喺外國結婚嘅，咁就即係呢個咁嘅經歷有啲咩感想？或者你覺得即係 art 係咪都繼續有咁嘅？ 動力可以去推動，令到香港或者令到我哋嘅世界。我好希望
art 係一個動力，我希望係 art 係一個好重要嘅動力去推動我哋香港。其實喺八十年代，我去決定做 art。
或者係決定做 video 嘅時候咧，其實有另外一批都係用 video 嘅一個，即係我覺得係我哋嘅夥伴啦，嚇咁佢哋係叫做 video power 嘅，咁佢哋就利用 video 去做一啲推動社會嘅工作。
To promote development of society and to empower the civic society. I really respect them a lot.
In the 80s, 剛醒的, Hong Kong 剛開始的一個公民社會, 所以很多東西都是剛剛開始, 無論是, 我們說要推動民主也好, 或者要推動藝術或者文化, 其實所有東西都是當時差不多是開始了。
Well, we saw the start of all these during the 80s. Just now, you said
that we should promote queer and LGBT.
In fact, the start was also at that time.
There were many activists
who would like to strive for something. At that time, I asked myself whether I would help.
未企穩腳，咁我就覺得，
我做咗呢一邊先啦，我會翻嚟嘅咁樣咯，
係啊。
So I just wanted to achieve one thing first, and then I will come back.
So
that means that when you come back, you have already got married, right? That's
true. 有啲咩喺講幾十年，你即係乜都做過曬，有啲咩你係未做過想做嘅？
非常之想做。
Is there anything that you would like to do now? Things that you have not tried before, collector.
I see.
Then you can buy artwork in Art Basel. I hope so.
我有啲咩問題，不如 open to the floor.
Now let's open.The time to the floor. Let's see whether there are any questions from the floor. Any questions for Alan?
Oh, 居然有張 slide 喺。
咁如果冇問題嘅話，不如我問多你一個問題。
If there are no questions, let me ask you one more question. Okay.
就係我覺得其中一個好重要嘅嘢就係
，There is one important thing.
好前瞻性咧，喺幾十年前開始，你已經去。Preserve 緊呢啲錄像藝術嘅
舞台，咁
去到今時今日已經我哋 preserve 咗30年一啲香港，甚至乎國際好重要嘅一啲藝術家嘅錄像作品。
咁睇下
即
係
當其時
點
解你有咁前瞻性想即係要 preserve 啲嘢，同埋過咗三十年之後睇翻我哋preserve 或者收藏啲作品，你覺得對於香港或者對於香港嘅preserved works. 對於我哋嘅歷史，有啲乜嘢嘅感想咧？即係呢個 preservation.
Do you have any feelings concerning Hong Kong, the history of art and history of Hong Kong and so on?
86度我哋開始 present the artists 啦。咁我哋做到97，我哋就開始有分定啦。咁我哋就有 office 啦。咁有 office 咧，咁嗰啲帶咧放完之後咧，就儲咗喺 office 嗰度。咁我就唔抌嘢嘅，咁就一路儲。咁去到
大約係2007
啦，即係都過咗廿年啦。咁我哋就發現其實真係有好多帶喎。
We realized that there were so many videotapes, more than 800.
Some said that there are 2,000 tapes really, including video tapes. So there are many, many tapes.
Mainstream media 裏邊所講論述嘅嗰個歷史，或者個 社會嘅事實係唔一樣，即係經過咗幾十年呢個 preservation 之後，今次我哋再就拎翻之前呢啲 individual artists 嘅一啲佢哋對社會嘅 documentation， 對今時今日尤其是今日嘅香港係即係好緊要，因為依樣嘢就係我哋嘅 memory 同我哋嗰個歷史一個好重要嘅一個 record。
And that is an important record of our history。
我覺得我哋今日所以用廣東話去做呢一個嘅 conversation 咧，其實都係好重要。
In Cantonese, I think this is important.
Because
if you do not preserve
history of Hong Kong,
if you do not continue to use Cantonese, then it will be forced to disappear.
今日好高興即係同 Alan 傾偈啦，即係我覺得 Alan 即係最後尾一個好小嘅 remark 就係，我覺得 Alan 係一個好 represent 緊即係成個香港呢幾十年嘅歷史，尤其是藝術圈裏邊點解我哋今時今日會坐喺呢個台度？而嗰個歷史係好緊要，就係即係譬如我哋 art fair 或者我哋好多近年有嘅一啲好大嘅 establishment 咧，唔係一個空降落嚟嘅嘢，而係有好多 individual artists 佢哋經歷咗好多唔同嘅嘢去 construct 出嚟嘅一個香港嘅文化又好，本土文化又好，而嗰樣嘢正正就係 represent 緊 Alan 一個非常之獨特嘅 identity， 除咗係 make art 之外咧，係涉獵緊即係成個香港好多唔同嘅發展藝術嘅機構啊。
Covers a lot of developments of different dimensions, like artistic development and organizations. Do you have any final remarks, Alan? Or you want to be a collector, right?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for joining us.